this lecture, we are going to see the operation of p-n junction diode. This is the symbol and this is the representation of p-n junction diodes in the top, right? So this p-n junction diode has two modes of operation, reverse bias and forward bias, right? We are going to see the reverse bias operation of p-n junction diode in this lecture, right? So what is actually reverse bias? Reverse bias actually means that the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the n-type and the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the p-type. So anode here is always connected to is the p-type and cathode is the n-type, right? And you can see in this figure, so whatever is the figure, I have mentioned that in the left side. So the zeros represent small zeros, right? They represent the holes in the p-type, and the minus sign represents the negative ions, right? So on the plus symbol represents the positive ions, right? And the free electrons in the n-type are represented as dots, right? So this is the representation of p-n junction diode, and this is the junction of the p-type and n-type, right? Right. So when you are applying an EMF here, right? So when you are applying this EMF, what happens? The positive ions, right, they will be drifting towards the left side of the diode from the junction. They will be moving away from the junction, creating a depletion zone, right, to the diode right. So diode right, the negative ions will be moving away. That you can see from the arrow mark I'm marking here, right? So the positive ions now will be moving to the diode left, right? So I'm just marking here, negative ions have moved from the junction, right? So they are moving away from the junction line, that you can see, right? Because of the reverse applied EMF, right? So reverse biasing is happening now. So they are moving away. So that is why I have marked in the arrows. So the size of the depletion layer is now increasing. Depletion layer or depletion region, so whatever you call it, or depletion zone, right? So it is getting broader and broader, right? So what happens if the depletion zone is getting broader and broader? The barrier voltage increases. So if the barrier voltage increases, the majority charge carriers of the p-type n-type, they are unable to make a move. If they are unable to make a move, what happens? They cannot create diffusion current, right? So diffusion current ID is not going to be created because of this applied EMF, right? So the EMF is not applied in the forward, it is applied in the reverse actually. So even if it is up, you know, created because of this depletion zone, the charge carriers will not make a move. So even the diffusion current is created, it is very, very negligible value, right? So there will be literally very, very few movements of electrons and positive ions will be there. Therefore, what happens? The minority charge carriers will be making a move, right? So the minority charge carriers, what are they? They are the free electrons in the p-type and the holes in the n-type. They will try to make a move now, right? So even they will try to make a move, the current created by them, minority carrier current, right? So it is created by the reverse bias voltage. So you can call it reverse minority carrier. So they are trying to make a move. So if they are making a move, so what happens? They will be creating a current, right? So that current will also be very, very low. Right, even if you apply low voltage here in the battery, the current created will also be very, very low, and it will reach saturation point very soon. So what is actually saturation point? Saturation point is nothing. Once something reaches the saturation point, it will not go further, right? It will stay wherever it is. So the diffusion current is not created, and minority carrier current is also not created. Even if they are created, they will be very, very negligible. Now we shall see the circuit diagram of this reverse bias operation of the p-n junction diode. You can see the p-n junction diode is connected to the reverse end of the battery. This will create high impedance path, right? Who is creating the high impedance path? The white depletion zone or depletion band, right? Now the diode behaves like an insulator because there is no diode current flowing inside the circuit, right? So there is no conduction in the diode, so that it behaves like an insulator, right? There is no drift current, there is no diffusion current, there is no reverse minority charge carrier current. So the ID is now equal to zero, right? It is because of the creation of the large depletion zone, right? So reverse bias operation is explained here. So if you have any doubts, please leave it in the comment section, and please subscribe, and please recommend a video if you want to watch in our channel. So thank you for watching.